What is going on, guys? Welcome back to an unboxing video, actually. This is actually a really sentimental moment for me because, you know, as the channel progresses, I've been trying my hardest to get a new video card for, you know, my computer to record some better videos. And a subscriber donated a card for me. I won't say his name publicly because I do, you know, I just keep his name out there. Obviously, if he wants to share that, he can comment down below and or comment in the Discord. But this is the first initial of his name, just so other people don't, I guess, try to claim it. just so we know who he is. I did, you know, blur everything out. I thought this was pretty cool. Ector Plays Inc. I think that's pretty neat. let's start unboxing this thing, and I'll do a little bit more talking about how this happened. Amazing subscriber commented in the Discord and just said, hey, I have a card if you want it, an RTX 4060, which is, you know, at the time of this recording is like probably one of the best entry level cards that you can get for, you know, the RTX line, I guess it would say. And obviously, you know, I was like, most of me was like, there's no way you're going to be sending out an RTX 4060 for absolutely free. but no, I was 100% wrong. I'm sure I'll have to blur out some stuff here, so just give me 1 second. Alright, I did my best in blurring out everything else. But yeah, this is the box. It's the Zota Gaming RTX 4060 by NVIDIA. 8 gigs of RAM. Freeze Tech, whatever that is, and Firestorm, whatever that is. That's probably some sort of cooling thing. This is the twin engine edition, I guess, overclocked edition. Oh, yeah, it's actually pretty neat that he gave me the box too, because I don't usually keep boxes, but I think I will for this one, at least to put my 1050 in. And the coolest thing about this one that me and Pio were looking at, if you don't know who Pio is, he's a huge supporter of the channel and a content creator as well. The key features of this, if it was the right one we were looking at, this one actually has the 8-pin connector instead of the dreaded 40 line 12-pin. So that's actually pretty neat. So let's see if that's true, and let's get this thing open. Enough rambling. All right, we got 3 boxes in a box so far. Let's go ahead and open this one right here. Zota Gaming on the front, pretty neat. Ta-da! All right, we're gonna open up this cover nice and slowly. Oh, that thing is beautiful, man. The all black, that's gonna look so good on my case, man. So clean. I don't think this card has, like, probably hardly any hours on it. Little backstory is, he said he got this for, I think, himself or his son, and it turned out to be the wrong card. He had it sitting for 4 months, and he planned on selling it, but I think he just never got around to it. Something told him not to. And then the last video I uploaded, I'm kind of giving like a call out, asking people to donate. He watched that video, and something told him that he needed to donate this to us, and super appreciative. So yes, it is the 8-pin connector right there, which I think I have. I hope so. We're gonna also install this thing too. It's kind of like surreal that this would be the last time my computer has the 1050 in it. Kind of emotional, but I think I'm gonna get through it. I'm a strong boy. Okay, this is by no means a tutorial on how to install your GPU, but I'm just showing you guys how I'm doing it. You're gonna open up your case. This is the NZXT H7 case. Wow, it is very dusty in here. I actually cleaned this not too long ago, so that just shows how dusty this thing can get. This is my Bluey figurine. I love Bluey, so I keep them in there. We'll keep her in there, but it's pretty dusty. right, so this is everything. I am gonna do a nice little clean in here. Wouldn't hurt, you know. So on my PCU, I have a 6-pin. Okay, there's a 6-pin connector. There's another one here. How does this work? 6, 7, 8. Oh, okay. So these two connect, I think. Yep, they sure do. These two connect and become an 8-pin. That is good to know. Cool. Okay, well, I guess that works. So we can just shove that back in there. And that won't be a problem. Okay, so GPU-wise, wow, I forgot how good this looks in here. Very clean and neat, which is uncommon for me. The side mount plate that I have to take off, I actually would like to get it side mounted. That would be pretty cool. And then there's two Phillips screws that I have to take out to get the GPU out.
I'll be right back.
I already took out the two screws. Now we need to reach back here, flick this little tab, and just pull straight up with light pressure. And there you go. This is the beautiful GTX 1050 that started the YouTube channel. Definitely going to be holding on to this. Oh, 1050 Ti. Definitely going to be holding on to this because I bought this from a retailer that is no longer in business, Fry's Electronics, and it means a lot to me. So let me clean this up, put it to the side, and swap it out. This is actually pretty cool. It looks like this card only has HDMI and I think a few display ports, so I can ditch the DVI or whatever it is to HDMI. I actually spoke way too soon. This card only has one HDMI port and three DVI ports. So I have these really nice, really thin, 10 foot long HDMI cables. So I definitely don't want to get rid of these because these were really nice and I got as a Christmas gift from a family member. So what I'll have to do is get an adapter from DVI to HDMI. Little unfortunate, but that's fine. I don't need a dual screen setup, you know, anytime soon. I guess I could technically connect to the HDMI on the card or on the motherboard, but that's a Pio question, not a Nectar Place question, so we'll just move on. Okay, we're gonna turn it on for the first time. Oh, so scary. Power cable. Ooh, oh, look at that. Little white light right there. Oh, Pinks, please be careful. Trying to make sure my main monitor is the one hooked up because, you know, obviously I've never named my cables. Okay, sweet, I got the right one. All right, let's put Bluey back in here and seal this up. All right, guys, I have the new video card installed. I'm booting up the computer and getting everything ready, putting the old card in the 4060 case. This has been a really great moment in the YouTube kind of channel, and I'm super excited. The games for the footage now is going to look amazing, and the quality is going to be so much better. I can probably look into getting like a 4K monitor or even like a 2K monitor, just so the videos can age well, because that's the biggest thing for me, is having a good quality where, you know, in 10 years down the line where everything is probably going to be 4K, 2K, 8K, you don't want to be watching these videos in 1080p. I don't know, I like to think of the future and stuff. I'm weird like that. So we can categorize that box over there in the box of reviews that I have to do. We are going to load up OBS and screen record. We're going to handle all of the updates, drivers, and everything that this GPU needs, and then we're gonna fire up Beam and G, bro. Let's fire up Beam and G and see what we can do, see what the difference is. All right, guys, I'm in OBS right now. I am screen recording. Let me actually sync the footage. So let's open up our NVIDIA G panel thing. I'm actually really excited for the RTX line of cards because they have the really cool, you know, like ray tracing stuff. I really don't care about that, but it is cool to have, right? You can't complain. But what's installing something, the coolest thing that I'm excited for is the kind of noise canceling audio that it can do. It uses the GPU cores to kind of like process the noise canceling audio behind you, and I've heard that it's very good. And also too, Elgato has the there's like a, if you buy their camera, there's a software that uses the NVIDIA, you know, processing to kind of like blur out your background, you know, give you a green screen essentially behind you without having the green screen. So, and it actually works really well. And I think that is something really cool for the stream, so I don't have to set up an ugly green screen behind me all the time. All right, I got a page saying RTX. It's saying that it's now optimized for a bunch of games. That is pretty neat. I'm sure I'll have to go in and delete all the 1050 stuff. I doubt that the GeForce app does that. So let's come into here. Let's go into drivers. And we're going to download the latest driver. Now, will it automatically? It should automatically pick up, right? Let me just do a check for updates. 416. Now, I do update pretty often, so I think that that is probably the right one. So let's see what it does. Oh, I'm so sad. My all my things are all messed up now. That's going to drive me insane. I really got to get that adapter. If you guys are enjoying the video and like video styles like this, I do have a tech channel. I've only uploaded one ever video, but I think that in the future, I'm trying to do more things. I have a review on this Boom Marm mic that I'm using right here. This thing is amazing. I only paid like $20 for it, $25 on Temu. And there's some, you know, pretty similar ones on the Yamazons. But it's pretty nice. It's not the style that I wanted, but it actually works great for what I'm trying to do. All right, we're looking at in-store. We're looking at some adapters. Okay, $12. Sweet. All right, I will probably go this weekend and get me a new adapter or see if I can just connect my other HDMI, which is my second monitor, which doesn't need the the RTX inputs to that one. But I will, you know, see what I can do, because sometimes the way I have my monitor set up is annoying. I use my primary monitor is not set up as my primary monitor in Windows because I like the taskbar on the other screen when I'm full screen playing a game. It's complicated. I know. I'm sorry. I'm rambling. All right, let's just move on. Express installation. Oh, I just did all of that, like sorting and stuff, and I could have just done sort. That's pretty stupid. All right, well, we can do auto arrange. Nice, that works. All right, graphics driver failed. I think I know who to call. Looks like I was able to install everything. What I did is I removed the old hardware from the add and remove option in Windows. So I just completely deleted the old video drivers, the NVIDIA video drivers. I restarted the computer because it told me to, and then I reinstalled. It gave me a few errors. I thought it wasn't going to work, but it looks like we're good now. So I'm sure it's going to do its thing, but it says we're up to date and ready to go. So let's fire up BeamNG, my guy. All right, hopefully you can see the BeamNG page. It's so weird not having a second monitor. I'm so used to making sure that I'm, you know, recording the right stuff. But let's just go into free roam. Let's go into the beautiful West Coast. Let's load up the industry area. So I have it set to where before, like my old video card. So you can look at the difference. Essentially, I used to play all normal with all the other options turned off. Just because in the beginning, I would get like a good 45, 50 frames. But once you start filming for like an hour, it starts to significantly drop to like the 30s, which even the 30s is still playable. I mean, that old car was a trooper, man. Hey, this hopper looks weird. That hopper looked good. That suspension looked great. All right, we're getting a 70 frame per second right now in normal. That is absolutely amazing. But I think where this card really shines is when we pump it up. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that, my guys. Should we go ultra? Should we just be ballsy and just go ultra? Let's just go ultra. Let's just send it. Okay, I got the card already, you know, nothing like blowing it up the first 10 minutes of using it. I think a good benchmark would probably be like high with some of the settings turned off. I don't know what the 4060 is capable of, in BeamNG at least. Wow, I loaded super quick. You can see the GPU stuff. Usually this is on my other monitor, so it's not in the way, but I guess we're using it now, huh? GPU load is 0%. That is that can't be true. I know for sure this GPU is working. Oh, it's already loaded, bro. I'm just talking for no reason. 65 frames on ultra. Shut the hell up. 48 50. Oh my goodness, dude. It looks so good, it looks fake. you know that, like, looks so good, it's fake type of thing? Oh my goodness, dude. This is absolutely amazing. Something's wrong with my NZXT thing. I'm sure there's new drivers I have to do since I had, you know, obviously a whole new system. Okay, yeah, there it is. Okay, let's How do I get that mini thing back? There it is. Show. We'll do show mini mode. There it is. Hey, buddy. Welcome back. Thanks for hanging out. If this GPU is only 50% right now, bro. What is going on? What is life, bro? This GPU is... I got a ticket. Ector CC, man. That's my plate. This GPU is only at 60% on Ultra, bro. Oh. I forgot that's a thing. That's kind of scared me. That is amazing, man. I know there's some options in here that I'll have to mess with. I think MIUI has a video. Or I think it wasn't graphical videos. It's just options that you can mess with. I actually didn't watch the video because my options were perfectly fine. And, you know, obviously I don't have a... At the time, I didn't have a nice GPU to care enough to you know, watch it and mess around with my stuff. But this is absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. You know who you are. I appreciate it. I don't know if I could say your name or not, but I do appreciate everything. I want to thank you guys for giving me so much support. We hit 2,000 subscribers this month. It's absolutely amazing. This is my dream come true. I feel like that's so cliche. Everybody who thinks... could you imagine a creator was like, yeah, this is... I guess this is fine. This isn't a dream of mine, but I guess it's working. No, this is realistically a dream come true, and I absolutely love that we have such a great community, man. I'm super excited. Down below, I'll leave a link to the giveaway we're doing. We are giving away a medium tier computer, kind of like a YouTuber starter pack. It's just a really, you know, not cheap computer, but maybe like a computer you can start filming on and getting your hands dirty and learning how to edit, learning how to film, learning how to talk to a microphone, because it's not easy, man. It takes a little bit of time to get used to. It's like it's not really a donation. We're selling it to you for a dollar for legal reasons, but you buy merch, put your name in the drawings, and then at the end of 2 months we're gonna pick a random name. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Absolute huge shout out to the gentleman who sent me this.